Tifu by cheating on my so and karma came fast. This actually happened about 10 years ago and we split up because of it. Before I go any further, I want to point out that I am fully aware of how shitty and inexcusable cheating is. I was young and made a mistake that I paid for immediately. This is my story. So one night my roommate invited me, 21 years old at the time, to the beach to see a bunch of people that we knew from high school and hadn't seen since graduation. We had spent all night in the bar drinking and taking shots. Eventually the bar closes, so me, my roommate and the remaining members of our group decided to grab the coolers from our friend's hotel and head towards the water to finish the night off with a few more beers and listen to the water. The waves seemed to be appearing from a void. This is about the time things took a turn. We had been debating getting in the water. But this is not very smart at night, especially when you don't know the schedule of the tide. Plus we were absolutely shit-faced. I was the first one to start heading that way, removing my clothes down to my underwear. When one of the girls we were with sprints past me, I turn around and everyone is naked. I admit that at this point I had not even considered how my girlfriend would have felt about this. And I got naked too. We had been swimming for about 30 minutes when everyone started splitting up. This was during low tide, so you could go quite a ways away from shore and still be waist deep. I had come up to a sandbar with this girl that I had been friends with for years. Neither of us had even realized how far away we had strayed from the group or the shore. This is the moment I cheated. About halfway through the deed, I heard my roommate screaming our names at the top of his lungs. We were the only ones left out there and the tide was coming in. We made it only a few feet from the sandbar when I noticed what looked like fireflies in the water. I quickly realized that these were jellyfish and they were everywhere. We both frantically tried to hurry through, but they just kept coming. There were at least 50-75 that we could see. Suddenly I felt a sharp sting across the back of both knees. I grabbed my friend by the wrist and started to pull her as I did my best to run, because now shit had gotten serious. I made the one mistake that every beachgoer knows better than to do. I decided we needed to get out immediately and climbing the rocks would help. I didn't even get a single foot planted because my toe was immediately sliced open to the bone by a clam. Now I am naked, pouring blood, and both of us had been stung all over. We started back towards the beach when I was doubled over in pain, shooting through my penis and balls. I thought I had been bitten by something, but it turns out a jellyfish had wrapped around my genitals. I had never been in pain like this before. When we finally got to the beach, we were surrounded by all of our friends who heard us screaming and had called the police because they thought we had come across a shark. It's now almost 5 a.m. and the experience had completely sobered me up. The police were surprisingly cool about the whole situation and one of them offered to walk us back to the hotel. Fast forward to later in the morning when my roommate had driven us home. When we got home, I started evaluating my injuries. I definitely needed stitches, but opted out because I didn't have insurance at the time. My penis looked horrendous, however. I couldn't even believe what this jellyfish had done to it. It was swollen, tender, and was a different shape. I took a handful of ibuprofen and took a shower before passing out for the remainder of the day until the evening, when I wake up to my girlfriend crawling in the bed with me. My heart sank. She knew I had gone out the night before, and my roommate informed her of my rough night, excluding the fact that I betrayed her. She was there for maybe a total of 10 minutes before I completely broke down and confessed, but did not tell her about the cut or the jellyfish. She never looked at me, never cried, and left without saying anything. I saw her about 4 years ago in a bar. She approached me and asked if we could talk for a while. She told me that she was never mad at me and that after some time she was just happy I was honest after the fact, she noted. To which I replied, "Well, I've got something else to tell you about that night that you're going to love." She ducking loved every second of hearing the rest of the events from that night. We laughed pretty hard about it. I paid for her tab and left. We haven't spoken since. Too long didn't T read. I cheated on a very good girl and was stung on the dick by a jellyfish immediately after. Damn. That's a story she'll be telling people for years. Talk about a parting gift. Got any crazy exes? Wanna hear about the jellyfish cheater? Exactly. And she'll get to laugh about it all over again. Second story. Terrified that my 25F husband 28M has been having sex with me while I am asleep. Now I am pregnant. For some context, I have a serious medical condition that requires some pretty heavy medication. It does a lot of things, including destroy my sex drive and knock me out for long periods of time. My husband and I were married before I was diagnosed. and he's supported my through diagnosis and treatment. He's a wonderful man. We used to have a very active sex life, and it has been a considerable strain on our marriage that I never feel in the mood. I feel like a terrible wife in this regard. And I miss being able to do what we both enjoy. To be clear, when I take my medication, I am dead to the world. You could blast a fire alarm next to me, and I wouldn't wake up. You could pick me up and toss me around, and I might not wake up. Lately I've felt worse than normal. Really sick, dizzy, uncomfortable act. I went to my doctor, scared I might be sick with COVID, and it turns out I am pregnant. 5 weeks. But I haven't had sex with my husband in at least 2 months. Maybe more. I did not cheat on him. I was not assaulted by anyone. Anywhere. That I know of. This was not immaculate conception. I told my husband and he was surprised. It's probably a million in one chance I got pregnant. Due to the medication I am on. And my condition. He was shocked. Then excited. And I was just so relieved he didn't accuse me of cheating that I didn't stop to consider why he didn't. It's been a few days. I've been thinking about when I first started taking my medication. It was hard for him to adjust to me not wanting to have sex. And he used to joke that I could just lay there and watch TV while we do it. Or, and here's what makes me scared. He used to joke that he could just have sex with me while I am sleeping. And that way I don't have to deal with it. And he can be satisfied. He's mentioned this a couple of times. But always lets it drop when I am not okay with it. I've started thinking about all the times I woke up in the morning and had uncomfortable pelvic pressure that usually only comes for me after I have sex. My husband likes to be rough and I don't really mind. We were always pretty wild in bed or adventurous. Or bruises I've had that I can't explain. I confronted my husband about this. About me being scared he did this to me. And at the least why he wasn't surprised the dates don't match up. He was angry I would accuse him of something so horrible. And insists that I am just misremembering the last time we had sex. The medication does play with my memory sometimes. But I remember the last time we had sex. I remember every time we have sex now because I don't enjoy it. I don't want to panic. I don't want to talk myself into being convinced he's been having sex with me while I'm asleep. And I don't want to talk myself out of this possibility just to protect our marriage. But I am terrified. This is the only possibility I can come up with. And if it's true, I don't know what to do. I've been heartbroken for a while over the idea that I wouldn't be able to have kids. Now I am going to have a baby and I am so happy. But what if this baby happened because of what my husband did? Quick update, I just want to say the response to this has been insane. Thank you so much to everyone. I am really lost and I don't know what to think or do. I am going to take some time to think about this. Get additional information and resources depending on however this is going to go. And figure it out. Just to be clear. However. Because there are too many responses to answer directly. No. I have never given permission for my husband to have sex with me while I am sleeping. Yes. I have asked him if I have ever instigated something while asleep. Sleepwalked. Sleep spoke. Or did anything in my sleep related to sex. And he answered no, we have never had sex outside of a time when I was fully cognizant and aware of what's happening. And, yes, I am keeping the baby regardless of what happened. If people are interested, I'll post an update when there is something to write. Again, thank you. Thank you for all the support and opinions. They all matter. Final update. I wanted to give an update as to what's been happening in the past 2 weeks. My first post got a crazy amount of attention. And lots of people were really kind and helpful. And I want them to know I am okay. This is gonna be really long. Just to be warned. To clarify, the medication I'm on for my condition is taken at night. Because it affects me the way it does, completely knocking me out. To reassure people, I would not be taking his medication if I had a baby to take care of. Regardless of my condition. And I discontinued almost immediately after finding out I was pregnant. Nor does the medication impact my fertility that has to do with my condition. After I made my post and read through about 300 comments, I think I went a little crazy. I convinced myself that I was making it all up in my head. I doubted everything I thought I knew. And I doubted myself. I went to the hospital to speak to my doctor about the medication and its severe side effects. I asked if it could make me engage in any sexual acts while asleep. I asked if it could make me misremember stuff. I asked if I was going crazy. The answer to all these questions is no. The medication doesn't make any of this even a possibility. And no, my husband doesn't have sexamina. Neither would the medication mess up my memory so much that I might not remember sex or consenting to it. This medication is not a sedative. After emailing with Myogen, who absolutely assured me her prediction of 5 weeks could very much be off by as much as the three that would explain my pregnancy, I had to accept that even if some stuff didn't add up, maybe I was destroying three lives for nothing. I never woke up with any semen in me. I tend to sleep in just underwear and I don't remember that being missing or wrong in any way. The pelvic pressure could be explained by the pregnancy. The bruises. I don't know. But people bruise themselves all the time and don't know how. I talked to a counselor provided by the hospital twice. I made the choice to seek out professional help long term for what happened. Things were bad with my husband. Though, I accused him of assaulting me. That destroys a relationship. I was pissed at myself. I've kinda spent almost the past 2 weeks locking myself in the bedroom. Humiliated and embarrassed and feeling like shit. We didn't really talk much to each other. And if we did, it was about the baby. I think I knew our relationship was over at that point. I went 2 days ago to get another ultrasound at 7 weeks. Just to check on the baby because I've been feeling weird. And to get the pregnancy dated again so I could maybe feel less insane. Myogen had a better look at the fetus this time. The original 5 weeks prediction was wrong. Even with a little bit of buffer. Time to be safe. I was most likely 8 weeks or just about as close as you can get. We absolutely got pregnant during the night I remember having sex. And to clarify, we never used protection because my husband doesn't like condoms. We're in a monogamous relationship. And I've been told since I was a teenager the chances of getting pregnant are slim to none. I was even more humiliated and embarrassed. We just fought after that. And he got really mean and cold. A couple nights ago we were watching a movie. And it was the closest I felt to him since this started. The fact that he even wanted to watch a movie with me felt like a victory. When it was over he asked if I really thought he could have raped me. I started crying and he started yelling. Demanding an answer. Before I could answer he started laughing and said he couldn't get me wet enough to penetrate me if he tried. It was him just being mean about my health. My medication doesn't just make me disinterested in sex. It makes it really hard for me to get aroused. When we have sex, we have to use a ton of lube so I don't rip and bleed. I told him that wasn't funny. And he said he really thought it was. We started to fight about my accusation and how it made him feel. When I tried to tell him how sorry I was. And how I was just really scared he wasn't the person I thought he was. He said I tried to ruin his life. Then he admitted he tried to finger me a couple times while I was asleep. And never got anywhere. So he gave up. And that isn't rape. I started screaming at him. Demanding to know if he was telling the truth. I started hyperventilating. He started screaming back that he never raped me. He only used his fingers to penetrate me. Only because he was desperate. He said I really hurt him accusing him of rape. And it can't be rape because we're married. And it was just his fingers and not his penis. And then he said he'd given me oral while I was sleeping once. Trying to get me wet enough for penetration. And that was when he'd stopped. He also admitted to using my hand to jerk him off while I slept. But only a couple times. So that's the truth of it. Our baby was conceived while I participated. But my husband admitted to touching me while I slept. But it's not rape because we're married. He believes that. He stands by it. And I'm crazy for thinking otherwise according to him. Maybe I am crazy. He's my husband. And I never heard of marital rape until my first post. I don't know what to do now. I don't have any family outside of him. I have some friends. But COVID is happening and I can't impose on any of them. We're probably not that close anyway. Making friends is hard for me. I don't have money. I live paycheck to paycheck normally and I'm out of work now. I'm scared to go. 2. I'm not stupid. Staying is stupid. We didn't sleep together after he admitted what he did. He slept in the living room. I slept in the bedroom. I think I slept an hour. Scared he'd come pick a fight again. It's been like that for 2 nights now. This feels like the end of everything. And I just don't know where we go from here. Or I go from here. He doesn't think he did anything wrong. And he's so mad at me for saying otherwise. Honestly. I'm okay. I want people to know that. Just really lost. I don't know if people care past this point. Want another update. Whatever. But I truly want to say thank you to everyone who cared. I'm not used to having people who care. even if I don't know you guys. It was really, really nice. I am gonna be okay. Shout out to all the people who thought I'm lying. Or some person posting a lot of fake stories all under different throwaway names. I just used a throwaway account because I don't want my real Reddit name tied to this. And the community rules said too. Even to the people who said this is fake. Thanks for at least making me feel a little less alone. It matters. Hit like. If you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing to our channel.